All right, Nails Summer Series, if that's what I want to call it right now. This is our second artist of the month, right here from Orlando, HK.
What up, y'all? How y'all doing?
Shout out to Plush Studios for allowing us to be in here and hanging out. I think this is Studio A. If you're in Orlando, you ever want to record, Plush Studios, where's that? All right. I wanted to do this because I want the city to learn more about their own artists from all over the city. Because I have these conversations with artists all the time that's from Orlando, but it could be an artist from East Orlando that people on West Side don't know about. And it could be artists in South Side that people in downtown or in Altamont don't know about. And I think this is a dope opportunity to introduce Orlando to Orlando. The name HK, what does that mean?
Oh, man. HK stands for my name, my middle name. Anyone who asks me if it stands for the gun, no, it does not stand for the gun. I got the gun on me. I got it.
Please don't bring it out right now. We don't need that.
Not the gun. I don't got stop. But yeah, it's just my middle name, man. Everybody be thinking it's other shit. And I just, that's it. It's nothing like... I don't want to say my middle name, so...
Yeah, okay, that's cool. You don't have to say it. I mean, we don't want to get governments out. So HK is like pretty much like a 007 name for you, right?
Yeah, in a way.
It's like an agent name. You know how in Men in Black, they say like Agent A, Agent J, Agent K. Mm-hmm. Yours is HK.
Because I'll be out in the field, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, I caught that. You said out in the field. I caught that. All right, so I get it. And I actually met you last year in 2020. I actually met you during the pandemic, and a lot of people use the pandemic to actually, I wouldn't say hone a skill or learn a new craft, but we actually had a lot of time to sit back and reflect and learn something that we wanted to challenge ourselves with. I feel like every time I talk to you, and shout out to Christian, because Christian is the one who introduced us, your brother Christian.
Yeah,
he's actually over here in the studio.
That's the main man right here,
Christian introduced us, and he played a record for me, and I was like, oh, who is this? He's like, oh, this is my brother HK. And I was like, oh, well, bring him around. I want to listen to some more stuff. I want to talk to him and listen to some more of his music. And I feel like after our initial conversation, I think we might have spoken maybe twice before that. After that conversation is when you started taking it more serious and investing in yourself. Because every time I talk to you now, you're either about to go to the studio, you're in the studio, or you just came from the studio.
I'm going again after this.
See? You see what I mean? Like, you're going to the studio right after this. Yes. And we're in the studio right now.
Yes.
When did you take it serious?
Oh, man. That's such a hard question because it's not... I'll say, like... doing action instead of thinking about it this year, like a little bit before the end of December, November, maybe that's when it really started. Because now I'm like locked in the studio every month, 20 hours at least, you know? So, and that just started. This is my second month doing that with this studio. So if it gets more serious as I go, you feel me? So I feel like I still need to take it more serious. Like, every time I go, it gets better and better. I work harder and harder. You know, I understand, learn more. You know, so that's, I don't know.
Do you feel like every time you go in there, the session becomes easier, or you get in a flow of stuff?
I mean, sometimes, yes, and I don't like it sometimes. Because sometimes it's like, all right, I've been recording for a couple of days now, and we're still on the same vibes. And it's like, I sometimes want to just challenge myself and do something out of pocket and like try to like work on a song for 2 hours, you know, versus to, okay, we did the hook and verse in the hour or whatever, you know what I'm saying? It's laid down, dubs, ad libs, all that. Sometimes I don't want to do that. Sometimes I don't want to rap or be singing. Sometimes I want to make like something different. You know, I like to stay out of the box.
How would you categorize your sound?
Me?
Yeah.
Me.
Oh. That's how you'll categorize it. Yeah, you.
I don't know. It's under like hip hop, urban culture music. I don't know, you got alternative rap, you got alternative this, alternative that, you got bubblegum, you got pop. It's like I can really do it all. But what I most like, if it was like, okay, you got 30 minutes to do a song, get in the booth, I'm going to auto-tune. It's easier. It's the easiest thing to do, you know, when you know how, when you do it for a long time. I remember when I first started doing auto-tune, I could not do it. Mm-hmm. But I do it. I played with it so much, it happened. So I don't know. I feel like I could. I like to be an artist. I'm an artist. You know, I'm not just a rapper. I'm not a R&B singer. I'm not a pop star. I'm not a rock star.
I love that answer. I love that you said it, because in 2021, right, every artist who makes music, not every artist who makes music is serious about making music. You know, sometimes you got somebody who just wants to get rich real quick. Mm-hmm. And then you got some people who actually put passion and time into their music, and they stop considering themselves just a rapper or just a singer. You're an artist, right? Because your music is pretty much a blank canvas, and you're making your art, so you're painting on that canvas, right? Just how you describe your music is you. It's not like, oh, I'm a trap rapper, or I'm just a backpack rapper.
I talk about what really, like, I express myself. I express what goes on around me. You know, I might get repetitive in a couple songs you might hear, but shit, that should be in my head. Mm. You know, I'm stuck with that in my head. I don't know. It's a lot of people, you can sound good. You can sound relatable. Is it you? Did that really happen? And I feel like that's what changes. I feel like once you tap into that zone where you're able to get real shit that happened to you and able to express it in a form of art that people will take and understand, you're doing something. And I feel like I just expressed myself so much that people are finally starting to hear it, and I'm getting better at explaining.
I can't wait to get the answer for this one right here, because looking at you, I feel like I already know what type of music you listened to growing up. But when you just said that you're an artist, right?
Yeah.
And you described yourself and your sound as you, but you broke it down a little bit, saying a little bit of alternative rap here, a little bit of, you know, bubblegum here. What did you listen to growing up?
Growing up? Well, when I was a baby, I listened to a lot of Tupac. Shout out Tupac, shout out to Biggie. They're always going to be
GOAT.
Yeah, they're always going to be GOATs, you feel me? Young GOATs, for real. But, like, me, I was like, my parents, my mom and dad listened to everything. They just didn't want me to listen to that shit, because they already knew I was going to be a demon.
Yeah.
But I was get off of, like, Jim Jones, Joel Santana, Ludacris, DMX, Method Man, Redman. That's about it, from, like, 6 to 12. Okay. And then I was like, who's Lil Wayne?
No, you did not just say that.
I was like, who's Gucci Mane? Who are all these people? Like, because I wasn't allowed to listen to YouTube. Like, I mean, we could go on YouTube, but it was like a child block. My parents had all that. Nobody knew what internet was, but my parents knew. They knew how to block shit, look up shit, so we couldn't get on that shit. So it was like, they would buy me CDs and give me a CD player thingy, the little Walkman. Mm-hmm. And I would listen to this fat ass CD player. I'd just sit there and listen to Joel Santana.
The anti-skip disc, man.
And then put it to Ludacris. And it was just, it was weird. It was just like, then I was listening, I hit middle school. Mm-hmm. And it was like everyone from different areas now. And they're like, oh, you heard the new Gucci Mane? You heard Lil Wayne? You heard T.I.? I'm like, who the fuck is these people? I'm like, yo, it's crazy.
Wow, that you know, that
South music, I didn't listen to Southern music until I hit middle school.
That kind of, like, I'm not going to say it shocked me, but that kind of just opened my eyes to not everybody was exposed to what I was exposed to growing up, and other artists were exposed to growing up.
Yeah, my dad from Baltimore.
Yeah,
he's from the north, and my mom from Texas, the west.
So you didn't get exposed to the Southern rappers we did.
They met in Annapolis, mm-hmm. and then came down to Key West. They didn't know shit about the South. And then, you know, as I grew, they grew to the South. And then, my mom moved from Florida when I was 18. She lived in Arizona. She went back to the West Coast. My dad's still here. You feel me? He a Florida boy now.
Yeah.
You know, he love it.
Your dad cool as hell, by the way, too.
Yeah, my dad.
Your dad's one of them OGs. Like, he's a real OG that everybody, he's that cool uncle mm-hmm. that everybody likes in the family.
He been through a lot. That man don't shed no tears, though. That shit crazy.
Wow.
Yeah, he don't shed no tears. I've never seen that man cry ever. Family died, this, that, everything. I just be like, damn. Solid. Straight solid.
But this is the part one of our interview. I want to do another part as well, but before we end this, I want you to tell everybody where they can find your social media and what project you have coming up, because we definitely going to dig deeper in our next interview.
I got a project coming up. It drops in December, though. I just dropped the tape last month, Trench Baby. My Instagram's TheReal407HK. You go on my Instagram, click the link. It's only on SoundCloud. I'm working on rights and things. You know, I don't want nobody trying to steal.
It's a process. It's a process, man. It's a process.
I need all my royalties. So, look, I'm working on it. It's going to be on Apple and all that. But now it's on SoundCloud. I'll probably get it on YouTube soon. Still, I don't know. A lot of people be getting mad and shit. So, Instagram, Real407HK. Link in the bio. Just drop the tape. I got some old shit too on Apple Music, but it's old. That's like 2017.
That also shows your growth too.
Just type in HK Hood Affairs. That's on Apple Music, Spotify, Pandora Music, Google Play, all types. It's on everything.
Snapchat, yeah. OnlyFans.
Yeah, No. Fuck Snapchat. I don't like Snapchat.